Hi, hello, namaste. Welcome back to Needs of Children. In this session, we are going to get the information about 9th standard English medium social science. In that, the part of geography, chapter number 4, continued part of water resources of Karnataka. In the previous session, we get the information about rivers of Karnataka. West flowing rivers and east flowing rivers. Let's come to the continued part of this lesson. Now it's about, we get the information about irrigation in Karnataka. So what is the meaning of irrigation? The artificial supply of water for agriculture is called irrigation. Maybe you can get the one mark question. What is irrigation? The artificial supply of water for agriculture is called irrigation. It is essential for the development of agriculture. In the places where the distribution of rainfall is uneven and irregular. So moreoverly, in India and Karnataka, we cannot expect the continuous rainfall. So that is the reason only in India, agricultural life is called as gambling with the monsoon. So that irrigation is very essential. It has been an ancient practice in Karnataka to carry on farming through the different sources of irrigation. So let's come to the which are those the main sources of irrigation. The main sources of irrigation are wells, canals and tanks are the main sources of irrigation. In early days, wells were dug in villages for the purpose of irrigation. Later, the practice of constructing canals to supply water from rivers for farming was started. As the big tanks can be seen even now, for example, Shanti Sagara. It is also known as Sulekere. It is located in Channagiri, Davanagere district. The wells dug in Kalaburgi district during the 11th century, the Tungabhadra canals of the time of Vijayanagara Empire, still it is existed. You can see the picture, the well which is located in Kalaburgi district, which was constructed during the time of the 11th century. Whereas Vani Vilasa Sagara, VVS, Vani Vilasa Sagara, that is Hiriyuru Taluk, Chitradurga district, and the Krishnaraja Sagara Dam, constructed by the Mysuru kings, are milestones in the development of irrigation in Karnataka. So, as these are the history how the irrigation has given the importance, agricultural as well as irrigation developments concept. At present, both river water and underground water are used for irrigation. Nearly 26.2% of the cultivatable land is under irrigation facility in Karnataka. Karnataka has occupies 9th position in India with regard to irrigation. Among that, Raichuru district has the largest area under the canal irrigation in Karnataka state, whereas tank irrigation is maximum in Shivamogga district, whereas Belagavi district has the maximum well irrigation facilities. But here, in recent times, the number of tube wells has increased. When the land under irrigation is taken into consideration, Belagavi district occupies the first position regard to underground or land under irrigation. In contrast, Kodagu district occupies the last position because of Kodagu district will be receives rainfall regularly, no need of depends upon the irrigation. So some of the main canal irrigation projects, if you are going to be identified, the main canal irrigation projects in our Karnataka state are Krishnaraja Sagara. You can see in the map, तुंगभद्रा हेमावती कबिनी हारंगी वाणिविलास सागर इट इज आल्सो कॉल्ड एज मारिकणवे अपर कृष्णा आलमट्टी नारायणपुरा मलप्रभा कारांजा बेन्ने तोरे हिप्परगी बैरेज भद्रा प्रोजेक्ट्स आर द वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट मेन कैनल इरिगेशन प्रोजेक्ट्स. सो दिस इज अबाउट द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ इरिगेशन इन कर्नाटक. लेट्स कम टू द सम कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ हाइड्रो इलेक्ट्रिक पावर. द क्रेडिट फॉर सक्सेसफुल जनरेशन ऑफ हाइड्रो इलेक्ट्रिक पावर फॉर द फर्स्ट टाइम इन इंडिया goes to Karnataka, because in India, among the states, Karnataka got first place in successful generation of hydroelectric power. So coal or petroleum are not available in our state, but there is a great opportunity for generation of hydel power. As a result of this, there are rivers which can be provide sufficient power for the whole state, especially the rivers flow towards the west. The rivers which are takes the birth in Malnad region and flowing towards the westwards most suitable for power generation than the rivers flowing towards the east. So the first hydel electric power station at Shivanasamudra was established in 1902 to supply power to Kolar gold mines. So this project was across constructed on river Kaveri at a short distance away from it. The second hydro power station was established on Simsha river in 1940. So the Mahatma Gandhi hydroelectric power station was established in 1947 near Joke Falls on River Sharavati to fulfill the increased demand for hydroelectric power. Later, many more hydel power projects were developed under the 5-year plans. So as a result of these developments, Karnataka ranks first in the generation of hydroelectric power in India. So let's come to the some of the main hydroelectric power projects of Karnataka. Among that, Shivanasamudra, Simsha, both are on Kaveri River, Sharavati, Linganamakki, Gerusoppa and Mahatma Gandhi hydro power station on River Sharavati, Supa, Nagazahari, Kadra and Kodasalli on River Kali, Varahi and the Marikanwe on River Varahi, Bhadra, Tungabhadra, Ghataprabha and Alamatti are the River Krishna. So these are the main hydroelectric power projects of Karnataka. So at last, river water disputes. What is this concept of river water dispute? Many rivers in India flow through more than one state. This has given rise to disputes regarding to the use of river water. Among that, the Kaveri water dispute and the Krishna water disputes in Karnataka are this kind of water disputes, river water disputes. When it comes to the catchment area of the River Kaveri is spread in Karnataka, Tamil Nadu, Kerala and Pondicherry. So the river water dispute between Karnataka and Tamil Nadu is more than a century old, but yet it is a burning issue even today. Kavu Eri always between Karnataka and Tamil Nadu. So river water dispute of River Kaveramma. When comes to the river Krishna, two flows through the different states like Maharashtra, Karnataka and Andhra Pradesh. So this has given rise to water disputes. Maharashtra, Karnataka and Andhra Pradesh. So this has given rise to river water disputes. So this is about the concept of river water disputes. So till now, in this session, we get the information about irrigation in Karnataka, hydroelectric power and the main hydroelectric power projects of Karnataka and river water disputes. I hope you have understood till now what we are discussed. In case of if you having any doubts, the entire lesson you can comment in the comment box. I will solve your doubts and I will come back with the next video. Until keep watching my channel. Thank you. Have a nice day. See you in the next session. Bye bye. Take care.